just, it sold me right there. So it's got to feel like really affirming for you as an actor.
It does.
So,
it
cool.
Does.
Well, we look forward to it, man, and best of luck with 500 Days.
Thanks, man. Gordon and the Whale.
Gordon and the Whale. Hit record.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thanks, dude.
Thanks.
I appreciate it.
Thanks.
Thanks. Thanks.
Hey, what's
Matt
up?
From IFC.
Hey, how are you? Good to see you.
Can you tell people what you're doing?
Yeah, 500 Days of Summer. It's a love story. I don't know, there's a lot of people saying, well, it's not a love story, it's an anti-romantic comedy. I think it's absolutely romantic, and I think it's absolutely about love. But it doesn't portray these things in the stereotypical way that Hollywood normally does. In other words, it's not full of shit. I think it's pretty honest, and our goal was to make it heartfelt and not just go for the gags and go for the, like, happy ending. I'm really proud of it.
Was that the quality of it that really interested you in being part of the film, that sort of honesty?
Absolutely. It's in the script. I read the script, and I felt like, wow, these feel like people to me, like not plot devices, but people. And then I talked to Mark, and he's the director of the movie, and he was really interested in making it, yes, funny, and yes, entertaining, but also true. And then I got to work with Zoe Deschanel, who I've been friends with ever since we made a movie called Manic back in 2000, and I love her. I continue to be inspired by her, and I hope to work with her more. She's one of my favorite artists alive, and
we hear a little bit more of the plot and what we see. He's doing some different things in this movie, I guess you could say. Can we hear a little bit about that?
Sure. Well, the movie is, it's subjective. It's not, you know, your typical Hollywood movie is objective. It's like sort of this, here's exactly what happened in reality. And 500 Days of Summer is more like, here's what happened according to this guy. And over the course of the movie, his thinking evolves, and so what exactly happened changes. You revisit certain things, and it goes out of order. And because when you lay down at night and you think about that girl, you don't necessarily think of it in chronological order. And so that's kind of how the movie goes. And also, it's more like how things feel than what they really are. Like, there's this scene that takes place after the first time they finally sleep together. This is this girl that he's been smitten with for a while, that he works with, finally got to be with her. And I've been there before, and it feels great. But probably it looks to an objective observer like I'm just walking down the street smiling. But what it feels like is that I'm dancing, and everyone in the whole world is dancing with me. And so that's the scene in 500 Days of Summer. We did this whole dance number, and Michael Rooney, who's this legendary choreographer, choreographed this dance number. It's called The Best Morning Ever. And it was definitely one of the best days of my life, because I got to be that guy in front of all the dancers, like, doing this choreography. You know, I never thought when I was watching Thriller back in the day that I would get to do that.
Have you been to Cinevegas before?
No, man, it's my first time at Cinevegas.
You've been to a lot of film festivals.
Yeah.
I guess a film festival in Las Vegas, that's a little bit different.
It's true. I think it's kind of appropriate. I mean, you know, I'm really glad that movies today have grown to become considered an art form. But that's relatively new. It's like in the 60s that people started to think about it that way. The history of movies, people used to think of it as, you know, a sideshow, or, you know, like dismissible trash. And that's our history, you know, and I'm proud to you know, work among the charlatans and the con artists, and I think there's something criminal about what I do, and there's definitely something criminal about Las Vegas. I hope no one hurts me for saying that. And I think it's kind of appropriate to have a film festival here.
Do you like coming to Vegas? Are you coming to Vegas before?
Yeah, I do like coming to Vegas. I mean, you know, like I say, I take a certain fascination in fake things, because I think everything's sort of like, well, what's exactly fake and what's exactly real, and isn't it all kind of up to you? And who's to say that that's not really the Eiffel Tower, or the Statue of Liberty, or the Venetian canals? Like, you know, if I were 5 years old, it would probably be even cooler than it would be in actually in Paris, you know. So I don't know, I think it's fun. Simulation and simulacra and all that stuff. It's kind of the most fake place in the world, Las Vegas. So I get a kick out of it.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much. Right?
Thanks,
nice to see you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.